Okay, so today we're going to go ahead and find the 1.5 parametric relations and inverse. Actually, it's the inverse part that we're working on today, okay? So what it looks like then, it's going to say, find f of negative 1x, all right? So if that shows up, then you know you're going to find is the inverse right here, okay? So what we have then, let's go ahead and say example number 1, and we have f of x is equal to x plus 5. Okay, now if the equation is given as f of x is equal to x plus 5, what you're going to do is you're going to change f of x to y equals. Okay, so let's change that as y equals x plus 5 right there. The reason why I want to change it to y equals is because eventually we're going to switch actually the variables of x and y. So it makes it easier if we just keep it as y equals instead of leaving as f of x. Okay, so that's step number 1. So now step number 2 is now actually switching the variables of x and y's, the position of where it is. Okay, we're not switching any signs, we're not touching this 5 right here or anything like that. We're just literally switching the x and the y positions. So now the new equation is going to look like x is equal to y plus 5 right there. Okay, so all I did again was switch that x and the y's, the position right there. So now this x right here took place of this y right there, so that's where this is right here, and this y took place of where the x is, so that's where this is right here. Okay, now whenever you do something like this and you switch the position, then put down something like this, a y prime right here. We call it a prime, this little look like a little notch on the top. And the reason why is because as we're continuing and solving for this, at the end, sometimes we may forget, is that the inverse equation, which is this part right here, or is it the original equation that we have at the end? So just to make it less confusing, we're going to put a little y prime right there, and then we're going to continue on. So the continuing part of this is then to get y by itself. So obviously in algebra 1, we have to get rid of is the 5 right here. Okay, so how do I get rid of 5? So we're going to do the opposite, which is then subtract 5. So we subtract 5 on both sides, subtract 5 on this side right here, and so then we're left with y prime is equal to x minus 5. Okay, that's it. That's your inverse right there. So we're just going to circle that right there. That's what this is talking about. So whenever you see f of negative 1x, that's the same thing as finding an inverse, which is this right here that we just found. Okay, let's try example 2, because I know if we get into a little bit more difficult examples, some of you guys will start to panic. So let's get into something like a fraction, because we know fractions are our friends, right? So first one is going to be then f of x is equal to, and let's put x over x plus 1. Okay, so we get a fraction involved, which is nothing to fear about, because we're going to continue on and do the same thing. So let's change then is the f of x into y equals. So let's do that. Step number 1 is going to go y equals, and we have is x all over x plus 1. Okay? Step number 2 is now to switch all the x's and the y positions. Okay? So now this is going to take a new identity, and that's going to be now an x right there. So we're going to say is x is equal to, and we're going to change all the x's with the y variables. So we're going to have is y all over y plus 1. Okay? So again, I didn't do much right here. All I did was then switch the x and the y variables. So this is now becoming x, which is this part right here. All of the x's now are substituted, and they change it to y's right there. Okay, so we're going to continue on, and we're going to solve for this. Now, obviously, we have to put y prime in there somewhere, so that way, remind us that's going to be our final answer at the end. Okay, so algebra 1 or algebra 2 says that I need to get rid of this denominator right here, and so let's bring the denominator over to the other side of the equal sign right here. Okay, so to get rid of that, we're going to have to multiply both sides by y prime plus 1 on this side, and do the same thing on this side. So y prime plus 1, and then so this cancels out right here, cancel, cancel, and now you're left with is y prime plus 1 times x is equal to y prime. Okay, all right, next step. Probably want to distribute this right here. So let's go ahead and distribute the x into both the y prime and also to the 1 right here. So if I distribute that, we're going to get x times y prime plus x is equal to y prime. Again, the goal is to get y prime by itself. So we got a problem. We got a y prime here, and we also got a y prime here, right? So what should we do? Well, let's bring all of these guys over to the other side of the equal sign. Since it's already y prime here, so since that's isolated by itself already, let's go ahead and bring that over. So to bring the x y prime over, we're going to have to subtract it from both sides. So let's do that. So subtract xy prime here, subtract x, y prime here, and then we're left with, this cancels out, we're left with x is equal to y prime minus x, y prime. Okay, I think we're almost there because I could see that we have y prime here, we have y prime here, but it's on the same side of the equal sign, and so we're close to it, but I need to have y prime by itself, so we need to isolate that. So the only thing in common that I could see is that both have y prime, so maybe we could factor out a y prime. So if you factor out a y prime, then you're left with, if I took one of these guys out, then obviously it needs to have a place value holder, so 1 will be a place value holder, minus, and the only reason it gets minus is because at the top is a minus right there. Okay, and if I take out y prime here, then we should have an x left over right here, right? So if I distribute this right here to 1, I should get back to the original. Distribute y prime to the x should go back to the original as well. So that's how you know you also did it correctly, is that if you distribute that, you should be able to get back to where you started with. Okay, so on this side right here, we still have is x over here. Okay, good. So we got y prime by itself. We got one of the y prime as well. We used to have two up here, but now we have one. But we want y prime by itself. So that means all of this right here, the 1 minus x, needs to go over to the other side of the equal sign, right? So how do I bring it over to the other side of the equal sign? Well, we obviously have to divide by it because right now it's y prime times parentheses 1 minus x. So let's go ahead and divide it both sides by that. So we have then is 1 minus x on this side, and we divide by 1 minus x on this side. So that cancels out, and we have left over then, I'll just have to write it on the side right here. So it was x over 1 minus x is equal to y prime. Okay, so then that is the inverse right there. So I'm going to go ahead and circle that because that's going to be our inverse right there. All right, that was example number 2. Okay, so the rest of the problems are going to be similar to that, where you're going to be able to find, using our Algebra 2 skills, is to find the inverse of each of the functions. All right, so I'm going to give you some problems to do, work on it, and then it's due at the end of the period, so make sure you turn it in, please. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.